full show of 8mm, you know, actually the mini DVs. I was started at 8mm. I started an 8mm film when my brother and I were 12. And we made a lot of 8mm movies. Made a couple of high eights, about three. Then we went to 16mm. That was sometime, I think it was 70s, might have been the 60s, 66, 65. And then we made a bunch of 16mm films. Then we moved to California because I had a job at the San Francisco Art Institute. I'm still there. And thank you. And I make also, besides my own diary pictures, which you will see, I make pictures with the students. It's a production class. So we get together and concoct a movie. We used to do that in 16mm. The budgets were very low. But I used to lay out the money when they ran out to make the prints. Couldn't do that anymore. It was too much money, $2,000 a year. I don't take it out of my salary. And they told me to stop it. So I was making, started making video productions. But by that time, the camcorder came out. It was an 8mm camcorder. And started making pictures with that. And then the camcorders kept developing and good new features. And then they took out good features and they put other features in. So the pictures began to morph into different things. Tonight it's going to be digital video night. And I'm interested in weather, so the first picture is going to be a widescreen picture, the only widescreen picture on the program, Vault of Vapors. And that's shot in Oklahoma. I just spent like maybe 3 weeks in Oklahoma, sitting in a motel, and photographed the weather that comes by, and anything else that walks by the window. Usually they're not very social pictures. Part of my weather diary series. Then we're going to shrink down to 4:3 and Celebrity Casino. My brother and I were invited to a film festival in Las Vegas, and we were given an award. I brought my camera and documented the red carpet. Then we're going to go on to a premiere here in Oregon of a picture that I actually shot in Oregon, I think it was 2 years ago, Coven of the Heathenites. Part of it was shot in Oregon, because I have several students who live here. And also, I was invited to have a show at the Clinton Theater, and documents the program at the Clinton Theater, and then a visit to my friend who lived further south in the woods near Newport. And I visit him, the dogs, and see the, with his new house. And then we go on to Provincetown, Massachusetts. It's part of my summer vacation series. In Provincetown, I stay with Mimi Gross. Her dad was Heim Gross. He was a very famous sculptor in the 40s, 50s and stuff. And she used to be married to Red Grooms, another big artist. And I visit her, I stay in her house. So we'll go see Provincetown. Then we got a little short, hairy horror. I don't know, I felt like making a Bigfoot picture. It's short, only about 10 minutes. I forget what started it, but I wanted to make a picture, so I had to go to the school to have some work transferred onto another format. I happened to mention, one of the pictures was about Bigfoot, and so a guy said he had an experience. So I immediately took out the camera, and so I made my Bigfoot picture. Then we're going to go, since we're at the school, the Libido Lagoon. That's going to be the big drama of the evening. I made it with the students. Stars Linda Martinez, a woman that lives a couple of blocks away from the school. She used to give shelter to the students who needed a room to stay, and that's how I met her, through a German student. And then she would come to class and we'd give her minor roles, like a maid. And then they accelerated and got bigger, and she's become the star of these latest class productions. Libido Lagoon, the students are acting. You know, we have to do it. Generally shoot like 3 hours. They tend to come in the afternoon, and even though it's class starts at 9, there are a few people there to warm up. They come in, then we have to concoct a scene. And we concocted this film, sort of film noir drama. Then the last picture, because I know it was mentioned on the program, was the Burrito Bay, and there's a vulture, a tropical vulture. That was a doomed project. I was invited, a Mexican student at the Art Institute I had 10 years ago, Miguel Calderon, wanted to collaborate with me on a picture. He wanted me to go out to Acapulco, Mexico. I didn't want to go. I said, can you shoot it in Provincetown? I was going to go there. We can hang a palm frond in front of the camera, make it look tropical. But then I overcame my phobia. So I went, and I had to improvise scenes. You know, he had a general outline of the script, and I improvised scenes. It was a big, elaborate production to hire a boat to take us to an island, and I had to get pushed in the water, and then I took this, they had me go up in a parachute, like a boat pulls you out, and I don't know why I said, okay, and they pulled me out of the boat, and I had a camera, and I had to do a monologue, but they didn't tell me how to land with the parachute that I was supposed to let go of the string. So I had a horrible crash landing, banged up my knees and stuff. And then the last day as we were leaving, we found out that the whole picture vanished on the hard drive. They didn't back it up. It's like a major disaster. It's only a hint of that. But luckily I was making this documentary along with the making of the picture. So it's mainly people at the beach, you know, they're going swimming, and then some scenes from the picture. And that's one of the few things remaining of the picture. There's only a hint of disaster with there's a fly that appears at the end, sort of the fly in the ointment. Then it ends, the movie ends. But if you haven't been to Acapulco, you might enjoy it. It did have a heyday many years ago. It's a heyday. You know, it's tropical, sweating every day and stuff. But the cast was attractive, so I took pictures of them. The crew was attractive. I was mainly the cast, and there was one woman, Nancy Pelosi's cousin. She was playing my wife. And she goes down to Acapulco and she lays in the sun and she swims for 2 hours straight in a pool. She doesn't get out. It's a big pool. She does a lap swimming. So and then Miguel's dad, he was in it. And then there was local people that they found on the beach. And also real policemen. I had to get handcuffed and dragged into the police car and stuff for a scene. Some of it remains, not much. We had a show at Yerba Buena with the documentary to be the only thing left. Then I'll come back at the end. Okay, thank you. Sure.